Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how to use Goodnotes Live with the Apple Pencil. Just so you know, I have the first generation Apple Pencil with an iPad 6th generation. And I will be doing a video that will be coming up is... I'll be doing a video on all my iPad and Apple Pencil accessories. So you can see what protective cases I use and stuff like that. For now, we're going to just... see how to use Goodnotes. So Goodnotes is this app here, so you go on it, and the first thing you want to click to create a notebook or to study is click this plus new here. What you want to do now is click, you can either create a notebook, so first of all you can pick if you want a landscape or portrait by clicking onto this. A4 paper, and you can choose a color by clicking on this circle here, white circle. You can choose dark, all, yellow, white. I prefer white. I have used dark before, but I prefer white, and I prefer squared paper. Not any other rule, narrow, anything, but you can choose as much as you want. And they also have monthly planners, month accounting, to-dos, weekly planners. And you can also create, you can also pick on the cover. So there's many different designs in the covers, and they're really pretty. So for this one, I'm going to pick this cover. Okay, I'm gonna name the untitled notebook. Let's just name it the digestive system is fine. And you just want to click create. So it's created your new, so this is your cover page. So when you click this arrow here and go back, so this will be your digestive system. So over here. Now I'm going to show you all these features over here. So first of all, on the right hand corner, you have these three dots. You click on them, you can copy the page, you can rotate the page counterclockwise, clockwise, 180 degrees. You can add this page to outline, you can change the template if you want. For example, if you wanted to do ruled and narrow, if you wanted to change. Scrolling direction, you can either do it horizontal, so you can either scroll horizontally. Drawing these lines, or you can scrolling direction, you can scroll vertical, so you can scroll like this. I prefer vertical, but you can adjust it to your needs. Stylus and palm rejection, so this is single finger padding, you want to have it on. Smart stylus is Apple Pencil, and you can choose your writing posture. So if you want this writing posture, you can choose if you're left-handed and stuff like that, but I've chosen this writing posture, so it's done. Click done. Over here, this is like just to put the tools out or not. This is to add a page with a different template. You can add an image too, for example, if you needed, or photos, just like a sticky note image, you can just add that image there. You can scan the documents, you can take a photo, you can import any file in here. For example, if you wanted to import a plan template, if it works. So this is just a planner template that I just imported on here. It's weekly planner, course name, grade tracker. So this is just monthly goals and my assignments and stuff like that. This is just a weekly planner that I did. This is somebody who made this on a YouTube channel, so I'll link that down below, the YouTube channel they've made this on. So anyway, let's go back to the first page. can kind of see your pages, favorites, outlines, maps for your document, select, done, close. Over here is you can search for papers, for example, search papers in here. You can bookmark this page, so when you're like going back and you're clicking on search, you can actually, where is it? Favorites, so you bookmark this page. So you can bookmark pages and you can unbookmark pages. You can export this page. You can export or you can print it and you can mirror the entire screen, and you just go presentation mode if you want. Okay, now these are all your tabs, so you can go on different ones, but we are going to the digestive system. Anyways, so let's go to the tool line. So the first tool is this tool, where you can kind of pick where you want to write, and you can write really clearly. So for example, you write A, B, C, D, E, or, and then you can rub it out on here as well. So that's a really cool tool you can use to write neatly as well. For example, yes, but my handwriting's bad, but if your handwriting's good, this will look good. Obviously, that's the rubber. Anyway, the pen option, so you just click on the pen again to get this page. So you can either choose fountain pen, ball pen, or brush pen. So if you like calligraphy, I don't know how to do calligraphy, but... use ball pen. So for the pens, you can choose different colors and you can use custom colors. For example, if you wanted this dark green, you want to click add to presets and it'll be in your presets, so you can have different color ranges. And it's good to switch colors. For example, if you wanted to write hi in this color, then you want to switch color, so you have about 3 presets you can choose from. Anyways, the rubber, you can choose how big you want to rub it from here, or tiny. I choose middle because that's the ideal. So you just click on the rubber, and then you can get erase entire stroke, erase highlighter only, or auto deselect or disconnect. So all clear the page. So for example, let me just write something. So but I normally use this pen in black, so you can kind of zoom in and you can write like this. Protons, balls, atomic, sorry, I'm doing atomic number, it's supposed to be digestive system, but atomic number, okay? And for example, choose the highlighter. So for example, you can also do the same presets, and you can choose how thick you want the highlighter to be. The pink, so let's just use atomic number. And the good thing about this is it goes underneath the writing, so it looks more pretty. Anyways. First of all, then you just have to disable erase highlighter only. So you auto, but turn auto deselect off, and then it'll be more proper like this. Protons and stuff like that. Anyways, so I've told you how to use a highlighter and everything. So for example, let's just do another one. Neutrons is mass number minus atomic number. Minus atomic. It's very comfortable to write with as well. I don't have a paper-like screen protector because paper-like scratches. I have a normal glass screen protector. So, shape tool. So it's a shape tool. You can also choose a pen you want to, or you want to, okay. First of all, let's show you how the shape tool works. For example, if you want to draw a circle like this, it will automatically identify it and make it into a circle. If you want to draw a square, you're gonna have to draw like properly like this. Or you want to draw just like a normal square like that. And then you can also have the option to fill color. So for example, if you want to draw a shape and you want to fill the color that you're writing in, for example, let's go to pink, and you want to fill the color in. Ooh, why is that a tick? You want to just fill the color in the shape. I think that's pretty cool. So you can just rub it out then. So now we have the lasso tool. So for example, let's write something, hi, my, okay? The lasso tool is you just go around it. What you can do is click it to resize it. For example, you can resize it. Or you can move it around wherever you want. So for example, if you wrote something somewhere accidentally, you don't have to do a star at the bottom and then write it down. So I think it's pretty cool. Anyways, we have the images. So you can choose your images from here. For example, if you wanted to add a sticky note from here, these are MKV's post-it notes. Please check out her YouTube channel. She made these post-it notes on Procreate. So what you can do is actually write on the picture. For example, if you want to label something as well, you can write something just like that. Anyways, you can also use the camera to take a photo of it or something and put it in. Anyways, you can also have a text box. So you can just write whatever you want with text. But the main point of this whole thing, so you can write slanty writing, of this whole thing is for the actual writing with the Apple Pencil. And here you can just laser it. So you can just laser the light. I don't know what this thing is actually for, but you can go and research about this. But I don't think it's necessary. Oh, if you like doing a presentation, I don't want this for. If you like doing a presentation, you're just gonna laser the key points. Anyways, that is all for this part, but I'm gonna show you something. You can import. Obviously credit them. So obviously if you want to delete something, you can open it in a new window. If you want to delete, just open a new window. So you can open this in a new window, and then you can open another one here so you can see it side by side. For example, cell division and stuff like that. For example, I've done this atomic structure thing with the plum pudding model and everything. Anyways, we're gonna close that up. So I've done this like here. I've made a little sticky note because I'm doing atomic structure. Anyways, if you want to do a folder, you just click folder. You name the folder. You click done. And in here, you can add as many notebooks as you want. For example, if you're doing it on one subject, atomic structure and the periodic table, then I'm gonna make another notebook of the periodic table. So you can add as many notebooks and stuff you want. So if you want to delete something, because I'm gonna delete these, I don't really need them, you move it to trash. Trash. If you want to delete this file, move to trash. Trash. If you want to delete this, move to trash. Trash. You can import this from your documents and everywhere. So up here is settings. You click that, you go in trash bin, and then you just click delete permanently, and delete permanently. So that's all.